U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin visits Zamboanga City as he kicks off his second official visit to the Philippines. Our correspondent Bianca Dava now on the line with that story. Bianca?
Hi, Ron. U.S. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin III visited the Armed Forces of the Philippines' Western Mindanao Command headquarters in Zamboanga City this morning. AFP Chief of Staff General Andres Santino and West MINCOM Commander Lieutenant General Roy Galido welcomed Austin upon his arrival. Aside from visiting U.S. troops stationed in Mindanao, Austin had a short conference with the AFP officials at Camp Basilio Navarro. Austin arrived in the country on Tuesday night, making his second official trip to the Philippines and his first under the Marcos administration. The U.S. official will meet with his Philippine counterpart, Defense Secretary Cagito Galvez Jr., tomorrow. Among the topics expected to be discussed during his meeting with Galvez and other defense officials is the Enhanced Defense Cooperation Agreement, or EDCA, which grants U.S. troops access to designated Philippine military facilities. The EDCA also grants the U.S. the right to construct facilities and pre-position equipment and assets, but rules out permanent basing. The U.S. Defense Secretary's visit also seeks to tackle ways to modernize the two countries' alliance to address new and emerging threats, including China's continued assertion of its claims in the West Philippine Sea. The Philippines and the U.S. share a mutual defense treaty, which stipulates that both countries will support each other in case of an external aggression. Austin's visit comes just over 2 months after U.S. Vice President Kamala Harris completed an official trip to the Philippines last November. Now, prior to his trip to Manila, Austin also visited and met with allies in South Korea. Ron?
Bianca Dava with that story. Thanks, Bianca. The Commission on Appointments confirms the ad interim appointment of Trade and Industry Secretary Alfredo Pascual. During Pascual's confirmation hearing Wednesday morning, Congressman Johnny Pimentel said the panel has established its full confidence towards Secretary Pascual. Pascual previously said his main priorities include helping upskill and upsize small businesses, as well as promoting ease of doing business to attract new investments. Filipino health workers will continue to receive their COVID allowances despite the lapse of the state of calamity declaration due to the pandemic. That assurance from President Marcos as he met with health officials in Malacañang Wednesday. There had been fears that COVID frontliners will no longer get their allowances due to the non-extension of the declaration. But Marcos said funding for the benefits will remain. Before this, health workers have complained of delays on the release of their allowances.
Some good news for motorists. Metro Manila mayors have signed off on the MMDA single ticketing system. The unified ticketing system standardizes fines and penalties against traffic violators in the National Capital Region. Under the new system, driver's licenses will no longer be confiscated during apprehension. Drivers can also opt to pay for their violations through payment centers or online.
This is almost 28 years in the making, and this is a very historic moment for all of us. Malaking tulong ito sa ating mga mamamayan, sa ating mga motorista. Malaking ginhawa ito sa kanila sapagkat una, hindi na kukumpiskahin ang kanilang lisensya. Pangalawa, kung sila man ay matikitan, pwede na sila magbayad kung saan man sila sa Pilipinas. Kaya hindi na nangyayari ang kailangan pang pumunta sa City Hall para tubusin ang lisensya at magbayad. Malaking ginhawa ito.
MMDA Chairman Romando Artes says they will take care of any ICT equipment that might be needed for integration. Motorists have voiced their support for the new system, citing the necessity of standard violation fees and a convenient way to settle them.